Hello, I'm single-minded Ryan, a game developer and a digital artist. In this course, we are going to create a typical 2D style game in a 3D world. But before getting into the details, I know you have a big question to ask. What is the core benefit that this course has to offer? The answer is that I want you to feel like you are making a real game from the very beginning. And I want you to learn ideas about game development with production-level game assets, so you can absorb these ideas seamlessly. This is why I put a lot of effort into creating the assets for this course, so you can have high-quality characters, smooth animations, detailed materials, VFX particles, and good-looking level modules to work with. These assets are great benefits you can get with this course, because you can use the assets to experiment with new ideas and design your levels even after finishing the course. Alright, let's talk about what we're going to do in this course. Our player can explore this world with 2D movements, so we'll cover these behaviors in GD script, including the run, jump, and melee attack actions. Then we'll learn how to control animations using a combination of different animation nodes, such as the stay machine node, the blend animation node, and the one-shot node. This way you'll have more flexibility when dealing with complicated animation setups. When it comes to the enemy, I'll show you how to make a patrol around the platform and how to detect the edges and the blocks so it knows when to turn around. These behaviors are achieved by the Rcast feature, which is an essential technique you have to know to deal with the physics engine in game development. Visual effect is also a big part of video games. I'll show you how to control the particles via the script, and how to create a material animation for the sword swinging action. Want more challenges for the player? Well, let's create a trap with spikes. Here we'll learn how to detect physics bodies using a collision shape, and how to use physics layers to manage the collision detection. Need something to keep the player alive? Here comes the health pickup. To make the pickup work, we'll finish the player's health system and heart UI on screen. Finally, we'll set up an end door as the destination of the level, and cover the game over UI and the restart game button. By the end of this course, you'll be able to export the game to executable files to show it off to your friends. If you're eager to improve your programming skills, this course also have a lot to offer. We'll talk about the core idea of Godot game development, the game lifecycle functions. These concepts are shared between many game engines, so understanding these functions will help you establish a solid foundation for your future career. You'll also learn about some basic programming ideas, like how to use variables and constants, how to create functions, how to use conditions and control flow, like the if statement and the for loop. We also talk about some unique GD script features, like how to use annotations and how to communicate between scripts using signals. But I want you to notice that this course is not heavily code-oriented, meaning it would be really great if you understood some basic programming ideas already. There are many things you'll learn in this course that I don't have time to cover in this video, and I'll keep adding new content later on. For example, I'll add new lectures to talk about how to make collectible coins, and how to shoot bullets later in summer this year. Alright, that's it. I can't wait to see you in this course, and check out the cool games you are going to make.